In today's show, Bitcoin suddenly passes $61,000 as a $1,700 hourly candle fuels the Bitcoin bulls. That's right. In today's show, I'll be breaking down the latest technical analysis from crypto analyst Crypto Ed, as well as Michaël Poppe, who points out that Bitcoin is heading towards $90,000 per BTC. And this just in breaking news, Shiba Inu creeps into the top 10 cryptocurrencies of the world by market cap, surpassing USDC, Dogecoin, and Polkadot, and now has that number 8 spot. WTF, right? Also in today's show, breaking news, Nayib Bukele, president of El Salvador, just tweeted, "It was a long wait, but worth it. We just bought the dip. 420 new Bitcoin." That's right, BTFD all freaking day. Also in today's show, Volt Equities Bitcoin Revolution ETF goes live on the New York Stock Exchange officially today. That's right, another Bitcoin ETF. Let's go. Also in today's show, CoinList CEO sees Bitcoin hitting $100,000 by the start of next year. We're talking about Graham Jenkins, the CEO of CoinList, which just got $100 million Series A funding, which has given it a valuation of $1.5 billion. Also in today's show, I'll be breaking down the latest from Plan B, creator of the Bitcoin stock to flow model, who shows us closing October above 63K, November above 98,000, and December closed at $135,000. We'll also be taking a look at the overall crypto market. As you can see, Bitcoin, Ether, and all the major altcoins are currently pumping and in the green. But where's the Bitcoin price likely to go next? Find out all this, plus so much more, in today's show. Here at Crypto News Alerts, I drop a brand new episode every single day. The goal is to get to 50,000 subs, and as you can see, we're getting so close. If you like getting that crypto, be sure to smash that subscribe button and ring that bell to turn on all notifications to receive daily premium crypto news alerts every single day, just like this. Now let's talk about some crypto IRAs. Today's show is brought to you by iTrust Capital, the world's largest crypto IRA platform with over $2 billion in transactions. With iTrust, not only can you buy, sell, and trade crypto tax-free, but also precious metals as well, such as physical gold and silver, so you can trade 24/7 and there are no hidden fees and everything is very transparent. And here you can see the cryptocurrencies you can currently trade, which include Bitcoin, Ethereum, Cardano, Chainlink, Polkadot, as well as other top cryptos. And a reminder, you can also trade physical gold and silver via digital ownership. iTrust Capital utilizes vault chain investment grade gold and silver held physically at the Royal Canadian Mint with ownership managed via a secure blockchain distributed ledger. And the thing that I really like is the fact they have institutional custody by Coinbase, the world's leading institutional cold storage provider, backed by a $320 million insurance policy, so you can have peace of mind knowing your digital assets are safe and secure. To take advantage of this, go ahead and use my referral link in the description right down below. And as a bonus, you'll receive your first month absolutely free. So what are you waiting for? Click the link right down below and let's start stacking them sats tax-free. All right, welcome back to another episode of Crypto News Alerts. I'm your host, JV. How's it going, crypto fam? Holla at your boy in the live chat. Bitcoin delivered yet another classic surge during this morning, October 28th, as the bulls enjoyed a $1,700 hourly candle. Let's go, Bitcoin bulls, as you can see here in the Bitcoin 1 hour candle chart. Now, data from Cointelegraph Markets Pro and TradingView showed Bitcoin breaking back above 60K after tracking sideways since early Wednesday. The move meant that the pair cast firm doubt on the recent bearish behavior, all but invalidating a head and shoulders pattern in line with expectations. And as reported, analysts were already unfazed by Bitcoin's retracement, with some even increasing their price targets over the longer time frames. As Crypto Ed points out here on Crypto Twitter, BTC, I'll be back on Friday, but couldn't resist to draw some random lines. Seems I was not bullish enough at $40,000. Quote, first target at 73K. Well, I think that target moved up to 90,000. And after a correction, we should see $100,000 per BTC, as he shares right here in this chart. And speaking of a $90,000 Bitcoin price, we also have Michaël Poppe, who says, going according to plan, Bitcoin might be on a way towards $90,000, as he outlines right here in this chart. Let me know if you agree or disagree with these crypto analysts. Now let's discuss the altcoin market, in which the dogs are completely dominating. Altcoins moved up in step with Bitcoin, with the top 10 cryptos by market cap seeing gains of several percentage points. Meanwhile, the market was still dominated by Shiba Inu, with the altcoin advancing 43% on the day and 150% for the week, as well as Dogecoin, which has been breaking out once again. But check this out. You have to see it to believe it. We had Shiba not only flip USDC coin and Dogecoin, but also Polkadot, and now has cemented that number 8 spot with almost $47 billion in volume in the past 24 hours, surpassing the king of all crypto at $40 billion. Craziness, if you're to ask me. Now, this is really going to blow your mind. This wallet bought roughly $8,000 of Shiba last August. It's now worth $5.7 billion, from $8,000 to $5.7 billion in roughly 400 days. We may actually be looking at the greatest individual trade of all time. So there you have it. And before I break down our next breaking story of the day, Nayib Bukele buys the dip, purchasing 420 new BTC like a boss, as well as Volt Equity's Bitcoin Revolution ETF goes live on the New York Stock Exchange today, as well as CoinList CEO sees Bitcoin hitting $100,000 by the start of next year, as well as I break down the latest from Plan B, creator of the Bitcoin Stock the Flow model. But first, let's take a quick look at the overall crypto market. We can see Bitcoin pumping up 3.7% for the day, trading back above $61,100. We have Ether up 4%, trading just under $4,200, while Dogecoin is up 32%, trading above 31 cents. Shiba Coin up another 22% for the day. Matic, Chainlink, Solana, Polkadot, Binance Coin, Cardano, you name it, all pumping and in the green. But all right, now let's break down our next story of the day. Salvadoran President Nayib Bukele tweeted earlier on Thursday that his government has taken advantage of the recent Bitcoin price drop and added specifically 420 additional BTC to the nation's stash. Now, we all know what 420 means, so happy 420. And it's cool that Nayib Bukele is one of us, right? Quoting him here, it was a long wait, but worth it. We just bought the dip, 420 new Bitcoin. And he goes on to share, ha ha ha, we're already making a profit off the Bitcoin we just bought. How do we make a profit if one Bitcoin equals one BTC? We have a trust fund accounted in USD, but the trust is funded by both USD and BTC. When the BTC part revalues in comparison to the accounting currency in USD, we are able to withdraw some USD and leave the trust with the same total. So there you have it. This is chess, not checkers. Shout out to Nayib Bukele making some power moves. Now, many onlookers have speculated on the significance of El Salvador purchasing 420 Bitcoin specifically, which we all know is popular slang for just blaze. Let's go. I'm starting to believe he's doing it on purpose, speculated Reddit user E. Garrett. Actually, now that I check, he was born in 1981, so he probably is. Funny to see the results of millennials starting to inherit the world. And as Pompliano shares here, it is absurd that the United States is being outcompeted by El Salvador for who owns more Bitcoin. Our national policy should be to match every single Bitcoin purchase that is made by a foreign government. The next competition won't be a number of nukes, but how much Bitcoin you own. Now, the value of 420 BTC is about $24.6 million. The purchase brings the country's total amount of Bitcoin to 1,120 BTC, which is worth about $87.4 million. The country has an estimated average purchase price of just above $53,300. Now, El Salvador first purchased two batches of 200 BTC on September 6th this year, snatching up another batch of 150 BTC a day later, and when it also became the first country in the world to make Bitcoin a legal tender, as we all know, on September 19th. El Salvador bought another 150 BTC, which brought the country's total holdings to 700 BTC. However, other observers were less positive about the recent purchase, expressing concerns over the security of the nation's Bitcoin holdings. Can you say FUD? Twitter user Dolomite replied to a tweet from Pompliano spreading the news of the 420 Bitcoin purchase, asking who holds their private keys. The user also asked what happened if the nation were to be hacked. Now, El Salvador's central bank chief, Douglas Rodriguez, told Bloomberg earlier in the month that the Latin American country continues to invest under the expectation that Bitcoin will soon lose its reputation as a speculative asset and become a legitimate payment system. Quoting him here, we don't see any risks, perhaps upside risk, Rodriguez said, adding that Bitcoin will become a payment system, a system for financial inclusion. That's right. And before I break down our next story of the day, Volt Equity's Bitcoin Revolution ETF goes live on the New York Stock Exchange today, as well as CoinList CEO sees Bitcoin hitting $100,000 by the start of next year, as well as I break down the latest from Plan B, creator of the Bitcoin stock to flow model. But first, let's take a quick look at the overall crypto market cap, sitting just under $2.6 trillion, about $179 billion in volume in the past 24 hours. Current Bitcoin dominance on the decline at 44.6%, with the Ether dominance at 19%. And checking out the top gainers within the top 100, we have Shiba leading the pack, up 180% for the week and 39% for the day. Secret up 89% for the week and 25% for the day, trading just above $10. And Dogecoin up almost 20% for the week and 25% for the day, trading just under 30 cents. Now, which altcoins are you currently most bullish on during this bull run of Q4? Let me know in the comments right down below. And now checking out one of my favorite indicators is the Crypto Greed and Fear Index. Shows we're currently rated a 66 out of 100 in greed. Yesterday was a 73, last week an 84, and last month a 25 in extreme fear. But all right, now let's break down our next story of the day. The New York Stock Exchange continues listing Bitcoin-linked exchange-traded funds, better known as ETFs, with Vault Equity becoming the latest company to debut such a product on the exchange. Vault Equity's Crypto Industry Revolution and Tech ETF will debut trading on the Electronic Securities Exchange, New York Stock Exchange, ACRA, on Thursday. The company's CEO, Tad Park, told Cointelegraph the ETF will be available for trading at market opening under the ticker symbol BTCR. Now, BTCR will open at $21, giving a nod to Bitcoin's cap supply of 21 million BTC. And according to the company, the ETF is implementing a management approach informed by Plan B's Bitcoin stock-to-flow model, a major quantitative model intending to predict Bitcoin's price. Quoting them here, we consult the famous stock-to-flow model as one input to understand how Bitcoin's mining supply shock due to its schedule halvings could affect Bitcoin's price and when. And based on what we're seeing, we could adjust our mining-related exposure accordingly, Vault Equity said. And approved by the US SEC in early October, Vault Equity's product is not a pure Bitcoin ETF, as it's based on companies with significant exposure to BTC. The ETF tracks so-called Bitcoin industry's revolution companies, including Michaël, MicroStrategy, Tesla, Twitter, Square, Coinbase Crypto Exchange, as well as Bitcoin, mining companies such as Canon, Bitfarms, and Riot Blockchain. Vault Equity will regularly review the fund holdings and allocations when appropriate based on research, data, and models like the stock to flow. Quoting them again here, Bitcoin is not just a coin, it's a revolution that encompasses miners, companies using it on their balance sheet, and everyday hodlers who want to hold the first digital store of value that can't be inflated by any government, Park said. Now, the latest ETF launch comes soon after the New York Stock Exchange ACRA listed a Bitcoin futures-linked ETF by investment company ProShares on October 19th. As previously reported, the ProShares Bitcoin Strategy ETF became the first Bitcoin futures-linked ETF to launch in the United States, and I know they crossed $2 billion in volume within their first 48 hours, breaking all previous records. And in mid-October, major crypto fund Bitwise Asset Management also applied with the SEC to list a pure Bitcoin ETF on the New York Stock Exchange ACRA. The SEC has not yet approved an ETF that would track Bitcoin's price directly. However, major asset management firm AXS Investment filed for two Bitcoin futures ETFs as well on Wednesday. According to senior Bloomberg ETF analyst Eric Balchunas, major crypto investment firm Grayscale Investments expects the SEC to have approved its spot Bitcoin ETF by July of 2022. All I know is this, once a spot Bitcoin ETF is finally approved, it's game over. So watch out. And before I break down our final story of the day, CoinList CEO sees Bitcoin hitting $100,000 by the start of next year, as well as I share the latest from Plan B, creator of the Bitcoin stock to flow model. But first, I want to remind you to smash that show more button right below this video in the description for a detailed analysis of what's going on in the crypto market. This goes for all 960 plus videos right here on my YouTube channel. Also, some very helpful resources for you to plug into, including my daily letter, which goes out to over 30,000 subscribers every single day. To subscribe, visit letter.cryptonewsalerts.net. Also, have a blog I update daily, which could be found at cryptonewsyes.com. Also, be sure to smash that subscribe button and ring that bell to help me get to 50,000 subs. But all right, now let's break down our final story of the day. The chief of a new and rapidly growing platform for crypto offerings sees Bitcoin hitting six figures by the start of next year. CoinList CEO Graham Jenkins is bullish on the cryptocurrency, which hit a new record high of about $67,000 on October 20th, following the launch of the hotly anticipated US Bitcoin futures ETF. Quoting Jenkins here, most of the folks at CoinList will bet that we're at $100,000 by the end of the year. It's getting pretty tight, so I'm not sure that we're going to make it there, but that's what we're predicting towards the start of the year. And illustrating the growing demand for crypto holdings, CoinList just announced $100 million in a Series A funding, which has given it a valuation of $1.5 billion. Now, a number of financial experts and companies see the crypto reaching and even surpassing that six-figure mark. They point to inflation and the ETF launch as creating a perfect environment for Bitcoin to thrive, describing it as a hedge for inflation. That's right, Bitcoin investor Paul Tudor Jones told CNBC earlier in the month that he prefers the cryptocurrency as an inflation hedge over gold. Quoting him here, "There is a plan in place for crypto and it's clearly winning the race against gold at the moment. I would think that it would also be a very good inflation hedge," he told CNBC's Squawk Box. "It would be my preferred one over gold at the moment." Very powerful words coming from the legendary investor. Also, Fidelity Investments meanwhile sees Bitcoin reaching $100,000 but over a much longer timeline. And Jurian Timmer, Fidelity's director of global macro, told CNBC this month that the prediction is based on the supply and demand model that he studies. The next and last of those two models intersect is at 100,000 in a couple of years. Then, of course, we have the naysayers like Jamie Dimon, who says that Bitcoin is fool's gold, but meanwhile, he's investing in it and allowing his clients to do the same. Now, check this out. Bitcoin bull Mark Yusko is warning of a pullback and calling it overbought, expecting investors to take profits at Bitcoin's current high rate. Quoting him here, "A pause that refreshes given how overbought we are right now wouldn't surprise me," Yusko said. "There is still some risk of the buy the rumor, sell the news." Still, Yusko sees any potential of profit taken as temporary and sees Bitcoin hitting $250,000 in 5 years. "Personally, I feel this is extremely conservative. I can see us hitting 220,000, which is Max Kaiser's year-end price prediction before the end of this year." And of course, it works very much in CoinList's favor to be bullish on Bitcoin, but the often dramatic volatility of the crypto doesn't necessarily hurt the platform, the CEO said and shared the following. "As far as any impact to Bitcoin price with respect to our platform, there's definitely some impact, but it really tends to be kind of separated between what's happening with respect to the Bitcoin price and eagerness from our community to get access to early stage tokens and offerings on the platform, so it impacts us less," Jenkins said. "And certainly if Bitcoin went to zero, that would be a major challenge for our platform, but we're not expecting that to happen anytime soon." That's right, Bitcoin is more likely to hit $1 million than go to zero. It is what it is. And checking out the latest from Plan B, he tweeted, "I keep staring at this weekly chart. If RSI goes above 70, like in 2013 and 2017, then you already know." And he shared this tweet actually back on June 20th, and it has been eerily accurate. He says, on-chain base, his worst case scenario for 2021, August, 47,000, which was right on the money. September, 43,000, again, right on the money. October is over in just a couple more days. He has us at 63,000, again, right on the money. November, next month, he sees us above 98,000, and for a December close, above $135,000. He also points out his best case scenario of $450,000 Bitcoin close before the end of this year. Let me know if you agree or disagree with this crypto analyst, and where do you feel we'll close this month of October? Holla at your boy. And now for a quick recap of what I covered with you here in today's show. Bitcoin suddenly passes $61,000 as a $1,700 hourly candle fuels the Bitcoin bulls. And I pointed out Crypto Ed predicting a $90,000 Bitcoin price, as well as Michaël and Poppe saying Bitcoin is heading towards 90K. Also in today's show, I shared breaking news that Nayib Bukele just purchased the dip with 420 new BTC. Also in today's show, I shared that Volt Equity's Bitcoin Revolution ETF goes live on the New York Stock Exchange officially, as well as CoinList CEO sees Bitcoin hitting six figures by the start of next year. But where do you feel the Bitcoin price is likely to go next? Let me know in the comments right down below. Now for the top three comments from yesterday's episode. Katie Lux wrote, "Thanks for all the birthday love, fam. Feeling it." That's right, it was Katie Lux's birthday just yesterday. She said, "Hoping for a huge post-birthday green candle explosion tomorrow, Thursday. Let's freaking go. Stock the flow, bring it." And lo and behold, precisely what we just witnessed. I wrote, "You're welcome. Thanks for your continued support, Katie. You're the best." And our next featured comment of the day comes from No Money G, who wrote, "Great show. I miss today, JV. In the coming months and into the years to come, people will kick themselves in the butt for missing the opportunity to buy or invest in cryptocurrency due to intellectual laziness. Only say that because I was one of them my whole life and only changed my ways in early 2020. Keep it up. onwards and upwards, Q4, let's freaking go. And our third and final feature comment of the day comes from G Dean, who wrote, hello, JB, great show. Tom Brady, give me 10 BTC and I'll give you your football back. Go BTC. That's right. Cheers, fam. One love. And to be featured on tomorrow's episode, drop me a comment right down below. Well, that's going to conclude today's show. As always, I appreciate you tuning in and journeying along with me inside this incredible crypto matrix. That's right. Bitcoin is the glitch in the matrix. And if you gain value out of today's show, be sure to smash that subscribe button and ring that bell to help me get to 50,000 subs. Now check this out. Janet Yellen escaped the loony bin and she's proposing a tax on unrealized capital gains, which is a direct attack on Bitcoiners. How can you protect yourself with a crypto IRA? From iTrust Global, the largest crypto IRA platform with over $2 billion in transactions. Not only can you trade Bitcoin, Ether, and the top cryptos, but also physical gold and silver. And yes, they are backed by a $320 million insurance policy by Coinbase Custody. So you can have peace of mind knowing your crypto assets are safe and secure. To take advantage of this and receive your first month absolutely free, click my referral link in the description right down below. Let's get this crypto tax free. And I look forward to seeing you on tomorrow's episode. Peace.